guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother, howdy, when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother, hey, when I shake mother hand that day, that's when I walk, oh, that milky white way, some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I want to meet God the Father, God the Son. Well, 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 I want to tell them all about my trouble. In this world I just come from, that's when we walk, oh, that milky white way. Oh, Lord,
my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, they came upon me to eat up my flesh. They stumbled and fell, though an host should encamp against me. My heart shall not fear, though walls shall rise against me, and this will I be confident. One thing I have desired the Lord, that I may seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his provision. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock, and mine head be lifted up above my enemies round about me. Therefore I will offer in his temple sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice. Have mercy also upon me, and answer me when I said, seek ye my faith. My heart said unto thee, thy faith, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord. Lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. Deliver me not over unto the will of mine enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me, and such as breathe out cruelty. I have fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Unto thee will I cry, O Lord, my rock. Be not silent to me. Let them die, be silent to me. I become like that which go down into the pit. Hear the voice of my supplication when I cry unto thee. When I lift up mine hands toward thy holy oracle, draw me not away with the wicked, with the workers of iniquity. which speak peace to their neighbors, but mischief in their heart. Kill thee according to thy deed, according to the wickedness. Because they regard not the works of the Lord, nor the operation of his hand. Blessed be the Lord, because he hath heard the voice of my supplication. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him, and I am helped. Therefore, my heart greatly rejoices, and with my song will I praise him. For the Lord is the strength of my life. The Lord is my salvation. The Lord is their strength, and he is the saving strength of his anointing. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. Save thy people. Bless thine inheritance. Lead them also, and lift them up forever. For the Lord is the Lord of lords. The Lord is the King of kings. The Lord is the great I am. The Lord is a mother for the motherless. The Lord is a father for the fatherless. The Lord is a shelter in troubled times. The Lord is my salvation. The Lord is the strength of my life. The Lord is my everlasting Father. Loved us first. The Lord is he that loveth us forever. The Lord is our Father. Rejoice in the Lord, O you righteous. Praise the Lord with harps. Sing with him. Sing unto him a new song. For the words of the Lord is right, and all his work are done. Trust in the Lord with all his heart, all his soul, all his strength. Blessed is the man unto whom the Lord imputeth not iniquity, and whose spirit is forever with him. The Lord is the great I am. The Lord is our shepherd. By his mercy and his grace, we shall not want. The Lord will lead us in a fine path. The Lord will lead and guide us into eternal life. For the Lord is our strength. The Lord is our salvation. Opinion that this is a fine time to get a Lord to anchor up a praise. Amen. 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 We thank God for being God. And we thank God for being God all the time. And we thank God for being a God to everybody. Ain't that right? Amen. 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 It's time that we give praises unto the Lord. Amen. We serve a good God. And I stopped by today to tell you that God is a whole lot better to us than we've been told that he is. Amen? Amen. Amen. I got something to tell you this morning. Amen. Amen. But first of all, the family have took the time to put together this program. And they got Brother Lynn Tyson down doing the musical prayer. Procession led by Brother Eugene Hall. Prayer of comfort. Then we'll have the scriptures and musical selection. And then I'll be back and do the eulogy. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Whatever your name, wherever you've been appointed. Amen. Your ways were higher than our ways. Your thoughts were higher than our thoughts, Lord. So, Lord, we just look to you this evening for grace, mercy, and peace. And bless this family in all the ways that they be blessed. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Testament scripture this morning is a very familiar passage of scripture. Come out of the book of 2 Chronicles, the 7th chapter, the 14th verse. It's a very important scripture. Amen. It's where you're going to find the healing for everything. We run to the ballot box to find healing for our nation. Run to the doctor in the hospital by healing for our body. But here is the word from God. He said, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray, seek my faith, and turn from their wicked way, he said, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive thy sin and will heal the land. Amen.
Amen.
Our New Testament scripture comes from John 3:16. And we don't even need to turn, do we?
No.
We don't even need to turn.
No.
John 3:16. This is so important, brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters, this scripture, if we would practice what God is preaching to us, this scripture have our young boy putting their pants up. This scripture would get people out from under the bridge. This scripture would make marriages that broken up come back together. He said that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. My God. My God. God so loved the world. Brothers and sisters, that don't leave nobody out, does it? That even got the bullfrogs and the tadpoles. That's everything. God loved it, everything that he created. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Let's see. Got my neck. Musical selection. Amen. this time, if anyone would like to make a comment, got anything to say? Anyone? If not, I have a minute or so. But don't get mad, I ain't going to say it. Amen. I'm not going to say it. But I'm going to say what I'm going to say. Amen. To this bereaved family. Amen. To the bereaved. Amen. Alberta. We know one thing. God loves her. Amen. Now that's true. I read you this morning. I don't care what kind of book about it or told you you are. God said he loved you. Amen. And brothers and sisters, that's why we done erred at. And I'm talking about especially with our people, black people. We done sent all our boys in jail. We done sent all our folk to hell. Amen. We don't give each other a chance to enjoy the love of God. Brothers and sisters, we get it all mixed up and we don't be. The preacher's so busy to try to entertain us that they don't tell us what Jesus did on Calvary. Jesus did some work on Calvary, brothers and sisters. Jesus did some magnificent, wonderful work on Calvary. And brothers and sisters, we got all the rights and opportunity to rejoice in the finished work of Jesus Christ. Amen? Brothers and sisters, we've been preaching all our lives in a way where we think we're going to take this old body to heaven with us. But we spend all our time focusing in on this old clay pot. And this old clay pot ain't going no further than this box, ready? Amen? That clay pot ain't going nowhere. And we spend all our time. We use all our substance dealing with that clay pot. Amen? Amen. Amen. And this is the scripture I want to talk to you from this morning. I want to talk to you from 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter. Listen to the book. It's 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter, and the 8th verse. It said, we are confident, I say, and willing, rather than to be absent from the body, is to be what?
Present
with the Lord. Now, brothers and sisters, you can't change that. That's the way God had it written. Brothers and sisters, it takes all the effort that you can muster in a lifetime to go to hell. I'm gonna say it again. It takes all the strength that you could muster in a lifetime to go to hell. You know why? Did you know why? You know why it's so hard to go to hell? If you listen, I'm gonna tell you.
Go ahead.
The reason why it's so hard to go to hell is because of what Jesus did on Calvary. Amen. Jesus did what we could not do. Jesus did what nobody else could not do. And he did it on Calvary. And brothers and sisters, we spend all our time here in this old clay pot trying to be good enough to go with Jesus. That is so foolish. Next time your preacher get up and start acting like that, get a switch. Tell him to tell you the truth. Yeah. Tell you about Calvary. Yeah. What Jesus did on Calvary. Right. Jesus finished his work on Calvary. Yeah. Jesus finished everything. Yeah. Jesus fixed it why you have to spend all of your life to die and go to hell. Yeah. Jesus fixed that thing, brothers and sisters. Right. And brothers and sisters, if we'll stop pointing each other to hell, you'll see people start trying to walk right. If you'll stop pointing everybody to hell, you'll see folks trying to walk right. If you will tell these little boys that Jesus loved them, you'll see them throw the easy their pants up on. If you'll stop telling them, they're on their way to hell. Amen? Jesus gave us the ministry of reconciliation. What that mean? Go tell folk Jesus said, come in. That's all God want us to do as Christians. Go tell the world, he said, come in. Now your mama's sitting at the body. Go tell him, I said, come in. That's what Jesus telling us. Go tell the world to come in. Amen. That's what it's all about, brothers and sisters. It ain't as complicated as the devil done fool us that it is. God ain't running behind you with no blowtorch trying to set you on fire. I get tired of going to church, having preachers talking about half of us gonna be roasting for the rest of our lives. Huh? That ain't why Jesus went to Calvary. Jesus went to Calvary so you won't be on no rotisserie. Roasting the rest of your life. And God said his word. God said, I take no pleasure in the death of the wicked. God said, I wish all men to be saved. So know what he did? He came down here and got in him a body. The book of Hebrews says, created for himself a body. He got in that body and did what we couldn't do. And he did it for us. Guess what the book say, y'all? I know y'all are read, probably read about it real fast. Do what the book said. It said, but they that are in Christ, sin is not. That's good stuff, y'all. If y'all like me, if y'all err every now and then, that's some good stuff. He said, they that are in Christ, sin is not. You know why? It's not charged. It's not, when you do something that's not right, it's not imputed to you as sin. That's what the book said. Yeah, you preaching it, tell you that. Yeah, you preaching that the word sin. The word sin come from the Greek word that mean missing them all. Y'all remember your grandma used to tell y'all about missing them all? You hear them talk about it in church all the time. You will miss them all. That's where the word sin come from. Missing them all. But guess what? When Jesus came, this is what the book said in the book of Hebrews. He said, once man have received the knowledge of the truth, there is no more sacrifice for sin. Brothers and sisters, once you introduce to Jesus Christ, these little boys you talking about is bad. Tell them Jesus and come here. Stop telling them they're going to hell. Tell them Jesus said, come here. And I guarantee you, the Bible said the word do what the word is supposed to do. And that's the word that God told you to give them. If you give them what God gave you to give them, the word will do what the word is supposed to do.
Yeah.
But the devil got us out here fighting on each other. Amen. He got us up here fighting on each other. He got my peers, preachers up in the pulpit, cutting up. Turning somersault. Telling lies. Using language can't nobody understand. What did he say? It's time God people, and especially in our culture, black people, you don't need none other sermon. You need to be taught. God said, my people are destroyed for what? The lack of knowledge. Brother, we need to be taught. And I guarantee you, man, you ain't that big a fool. If you knew better, you would do better.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Your folk wouldn't go to church cutting up like that if they knew better. You wouldn't mock it. This is what the book said. I'm gonna ask y'all, do this make any sense? He said, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. All right, on Sunday, sneak around and trick to see if you hear Jehovah God? Or do you hear chaos? Huh? It's chaos. It's not a joyful noise. It's chaos. Brother and sister, we got to get this thing right. God gave us an opportunity now to get it right. God has shut out all these churches. All these churches couldn't have been shut out if that memo didn't go by his desk. He had to approve it all for that to happen. But you know what, brothers and sisters? Did you not get an assembly line and a plant? If you ain't producing nothing, you might as well shut the line down. Amen? You might as well shut it down if you ain't producing nothing. So, brothers and sisters, am I right about it? Have we been producing anything? Come on here now.
Chaos.
Come on here now. Chaos.
Yeah.
Come on here. Nobody being blessed but the pastor. Everybody at lead church, $2 y'all. Amen. But this is what I was trying to preach to you about. He said to be absent from the body is to be present with God. Brothers and sisters, God loves us. God wants us with him. God don't want none of us to go to hell. That's what he came and did to work for us. So we won't have to go to hell. And brothers and sisters, I believe we start telling each other what Jesus said. If we'll start saying what Jesus said, you'll see a change in people. Because ain't no word got no power in it. Oh my God. But God's word. That stuff you make up and sound cute, that ain't God's word. These programs that we have in church, folks stand up on the roster, them long, pretty speeches, that ain't God's word. It ain't gonna do nothing for you. Can't nothing change you, your situation, but the word of God. God put power in his word. It is power in the word of God.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing in you. And if you notice why Jesus was here, read John 16 and 17. Jesus said everything that God said. And that's what he wants us to do, brothers and sisters. Let's say what Jesus said and see what happened in our community. Let's say what Jesus said and see what be happening in our revival. Amen. You'll stop having revival to raise money. And we'll start having revival to turn people back to God. Because that's our ministry. Our ministry, everybody got that ministry of reconciliation. And what I say that mean? Go tell them what? Jesus said, come here. Amen. And he gave all us that ministry. Not just to the Jews. The Bible said in John 1 and 12, he said, he came to his own. But his own received him not. But he said, to as many as received him, to them gave he the power to be sons of God. In other words, brothers and sisters, he tore down that middle wall of partition and preached to the Gentiles. Say, I don't care what you did last night. I don't care what you did last week. Come here. Amen. He talking to me and you. Come here. And brother and sister, don't think like we've been preaching wrong. We know that. Don't think, brother and sister, you done went too far and stayed too long. Brother and sister, you still got time. Today is a good time. Come here. Today is a good time to come here. Ain't no church out here for you to join. But you can come up and recommit your life to God. You could do that right now. You could do that right now. While this musician is playing, you could come up here right now. Everybody stand. Everybody stand there. Everybody stand. Right now, if you want to come up and recommit your life to God, you could come right up here now to the altar and recommit your life to God if you want to. And brother, sister, ain't nobody out here got no room to talk about you if you call.
That's right.
Because them that didn't come need to come. Jesus said, come here, y'all. Jesus said, come here. Come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden. He said, I will give you rest. Jesus said, come in. Amen. Thank you so much.
Household gone, the voice we love is still. A place is vacant in our home that can never be filled. We cannot tell who next may fall beneath the chosen rod. One must be first, so let us all prepare to meet our God. The family of Mrs. Alberta Mercer Jacobs would like to say thank you to each of you who have come to help bear their griefs, your calls, visits, prayers, kindness, and acts and deeds during the passing of their loved one will never be forgotten. Floral offerings that have been sent to the family with deepest sympathy, please accept our heartfelt and deepest sympathy for your loss. Family and friends of Mrs. Jacobs, you are in our thoughts and prayers, Southern Company services, co-workers, and friends. In loving memory of Mrs. Alberta M. Jacobs, your Southern Company family. Auntie Sweetie, rest in paradise. We would love you forever. Love Angela, Brandon, India, and Kim. Thinking of you and your family, Southern Company. With deepest sympathy, Nana, Lisa, Papa Joe, and Lindsay O. The family flower is in loving memory of Mrs. Alberta Mercer Jacobs. In loving memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and President, and the staff of the J.W. Williams Funeral Home, we would like to present this family an African-American heirloom Bible in hopes that it will serve as a source of comfort and peace. The J.W. Williams Funeral Home is also pleased to present to this family a pictorial tribute of your loved one that you may cherish the many memories that you shared as a family. Also, the J.W. Williams Funeral Home would like to present to this family a memorial keepsake blanket. May it be a reminder of the love that each of you have shared.
Once again, our brothers and sisters, sorrow has invaded our ranks once again and took away one of our deeply beloved. But there become a time in all our lives when those things that belong to the earth go back to the earth. Those things belong to the spirit, return to the spirit. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust. We commit this body on this day in the name of Jesus. Amen.